Welcome to Highfalutin Low Carb, the weekly web series where we find and test the best low carb recipe.
Hey guys, good morning. I bet I look amazing. It's early on a Monday morning. Don't get worried, nothing's gone wrong with the other show. It'll be back. I just wanted to try something a little bit different. I've wondered how I'm very sleepy. I've often wondered how sweeteners, artificial sweeteners, real sweeteners, affect my blood sugar. So I've devised a little plan wherein every morning I'm going to get up and have a couple of cups of coffee, just like I normally do. And each morning I'm going to put in a different sugar or sugar substitute. And then I'm going to use my handy dandy, that thing, to test my blood sugar and see how this goes, so I can definitively know if erythritol does or does not spike my blood sugar, or monk fruit, or equal, or sweet and low, whatever they may be. It's a little unnerving knowing that I'm going to start out my days, for the next few days at least, with something that could possibly spike my blood sugar. But this is in the name of science. So I'm kind of quietly speaking because the house is still asleep. It's very early here, as you can tell. So, I'm going to test my blood sugar this morning before I have any coffee. And then today I'm not using any sweetener, just doing like I normally do with heavy whipping cream, just a tablespoon of that. So we'll test that to get a baseline of what my blood sugar does in the morning, and we'll go from there. All right, guys. Whew. It's amazing how terrible I look in a ring light at 5:45 in the morning. All right, I'll meet you back here every morning. It's a date. Bye, guys. Hey, guys. We're back this morning. Blood sugar rose a little bit yesterday from like 80 to 100 within the hour of getting up. Didn't have any sugar in my coffee. Did have 2 tablespoons of whipping cream. So we're going to do some black coffee one day this week as well, just to test that. Today is going to be erythritol. So let me get a quick blood sugar reading for this morning. Because I need some coffee. Yeah, sleepy. Feels odd letting people see your bedhead in morning sleepy time face. All of these things are so fiddly and sharp. That's a lot to deal with in the morning, to be honest with you. If you're diabetic, this isn't fun, I guess. I'm not diabetic. I just happen to have one of these that I wanted to test sugar with just for dietary reasons. Oh. Hate that thing. All right, let's see what it is. 96 this morning. Anyway, I'm gonna go drink some coffee. Bye, guys. Okay, good morning. We're back. Again, very sleepy this morning. I ran out of test strips yesterday, so I had to take a hiatus for one day. But we're gonna resume today, and damn, these things are expensive. It's like $29 for 25 of these. That's cuckoo. And because I don't really need them for medical reasons, obviously my insurance doesn't cover them. So let's do this again. Today, what are we gonna have? Today is gonna be Splenda. Which I'm scared of. And I don't really like. But all in the name of science, guys. All in the name of science. Oh, Lord, are you kidding me? Jesus Christ. Okay. Okay, let's do this one. Are you ready? This is going to hurt. I don't like these. Ow. 102. All right. Time for coffee. Good morning, guys. It's the weekend. I'm trying to be quiet. We've actually got some family in the house today. We had a family reunion. I did pretty well. I was actually kind of scared about that because, as you can imagine, a family reunion in the South involves tons of food. but I did well. Anyway, today I think I'm going to test monk fruit, the new Naturals brand monk fruit. A very dear friend of mine from college. Hi, Elin. We were chatting on Facebook and she told me the wonderful things about monk fruit. And I told her I was skeptical of it because I'd heard so much about the In The Raw brand, which obviously is mixed with dextrose and maltodextrin. And I said I was scared it was going to spike me. And she told me of the new Naturals brand, which is supposedly only monk fruit. And in fact, it comes in like a salt shaker situation where you shake it on your food because you have to use so little of it. I think it says something like 1/64 of a teaspoon is equivalent to 2 teaspoons of sugar. So this stuff is crazy strong. So I'm gonna try that today and see how it goes. I'm filming. I'll be just 1 minute. I guess I need to go. Hey guys. Guess what? It's Monday morning again. Boo. Had a wonderful weekend. Had family in town for a big family reunion. Anyway, I think today I'm gonna do one of the sweeteners that I avoided last week and I don't really want to do, and that's odd to say, but it's sugar. I'm just curious what it does, but it's frustrating to know that, you know, everybody wants to start a diet on a Monday morning and here I will be basically sabotaging that in some way, all in the name of this, whatever this project is that I'm trying to find out. Hold on, let me let the dog out. And come on, shoo. I'm trying to keep it about a 2 teaspoon equivalent for all of these sweeteners per cup of coffee, and I'm having 2 cups of coffee. I'm actually having 3, but I'm only putting 3. Yeah, talk about gluttony. I actually have 3, but I'm only putting sweeteners in the first 2, which I down pretty quickly to try to get the sugar into me and the caffeine. So anyway, I'm rambling this morning. Let's take our sugar here and see what it is this Monday morning. Okay, here we go. Go! Surprises you every time. Okay, I've just sat down out here and with my first cup of coffee of the morning, and I really wanted to make a big deal of it and say, oh yeah, sugar tastes terrible. I'm so good now, I don't even like sugar. That would be a big lie to you and me. It tastes like magic. So I'm gonna sit out here and enjoy it and hope to God it doesn't screw me up for the rest of the day and cause me to crave everything under the sun. I don't need that on a Monday. We gotta talk. I usually don't do a video update after I drink my coffee. I just take a photo of my blood sugar. I don't know if you can see that, if it'll focus on that, because it's focusing on me. 145. An hour out now, a little less than an hour, and my sugar has gone from 100 to 145. So wowzers. I'm not looking forward to the rest of the day because of that either. Anyway, I just wanted to let you know. That sucks. Bye. Good morning. Here we are again. It is wicked early this morning. I've been putting off testing the pink and the blue stuff. The sweet and low and the equal, because I hate them. So no matter what it says with my blood sugar, I will never use them just because they taste terrible and make me feel terrible. So, but I want to do it in the name of science here, so let's see what we've got. Oops. Oh, damn. My machine is in the kitchen charging. I'll be back. Hold on. Okay. Now I've got to stick myself again. These things are fiddly. Oh, it's still bleeding. You smash on it. And that's a dirty one, old one. Jesus Christ. It's too early to be doing. Ow! I literally pinched my finger in the jar. God. Gonna be coagulated by the time it gets here. Come on. Fire up. It's a little high. 102. I mean, I guess that's high. I don't really know. I mean, some days it's been 80 in the morning and some days it's been 100. So, all right. I'm gonna go drink some coffee. I think I'll do the blue stuff today. The equal. So, meet you in the morning. Okay. 100 again, almost right on. So, today we're going to try a product that I really like, and I have some suspicions that it probably does spike my blood sugar. I'm not sure. Yikes, my shirt's climbing off. Fibre Syrup. Let's try to get it in the light. Can you see that? Fibre Syrup Gold. This stuff is from Denmark, and it claims to have, per 2 tablespoons, 30 total carbohydrates, 28 of which are fiber, and 2 of which are sugars. We're going to see if that's true. This stuff is delicious. That's the I hope it doesn't spike me, because I love this stuff. As you see, the bottle is almost all gone. It tastes like pancake syrup, and I ain't joking. It is good. So say a little prayer for me that this doesn't spike my blood sugar, because I love it. It's so good. So I don't know how it's going to go in coffee. I probably wouldn't put pancake syrup in my coffee, but just for the purposes of this making everything equal and this test working out, I'm going to use it as coffee sweetener for today, following the same exact rules, using the same average quantities of 2 teaspoons per cup. All right, so I'm going to record this. I'm going to make some coffee, and let's do this again. Oh my God. I cannot use fiber syrup ever again. This magic stuff that I was talking about, how fantastic it was, there's a reason that it's so fantastic. 189. One serving size is 2 tablespoons of this. I used 4 teaspoons, 2 teaspoons in each cup of coffee that I had, in the first 2 cups of coffee, and my usual creamer. I usually have a blood sugar rise of 10 or 15 points, and that's probably from the creamer. We're going to test that later in the week. I'm going to have the coffee without the cream, probably tomorrow. Y'all, 89 points my blood sugar shot up. That was more than the sugar. I used pure sugar, 4 teaspoons of pure sugar, and my blood sugar only went up to 147. It is at 189. Gosh. Sucrin Fibre Syrup Gold. Can't do it anymore, sugar booger. Gonna have to throw you in the garbage. Damn. That stuff is good. Yeah, it's pure sugar. Good morning, guys. I do believe this is the last day of this little project we've been doing here together. It's almost been two weeks, I think. I don't know exactly how many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it's been 11 days, about 12 days. There were a couple of days missed in there. So we've hit and touched on most all of the major sweeteners. I believe I got them all. So today is the last day. I'm going to do coffee with no cream today. Just black coffee, the same brand of coffee I've been using all week. And we'll go from there just to see how much the creamer actually has been affecting my sugar. And then I'm going to compile all of this today or tomorrow. I just want to reiterate, and I'm probably going to say this in a better way, but later when I'm awake, I am not a doctor. I am not diabetic. I have not been trained in how to do any of this. This is just a project for me, a project for me to tell myself how these things have affected me. And I had one little shock there, as you know, with that Sucrin Fibre Gold. What a disappointment. And had I not done this, how many days, weeks, months, years would I have gone pouring that stuff on and just, yeah, this is low carb. Yeah, it's not affecting me a bit. And meanwhile, my blood sugar was through the roof. So, channel will be back to normal next week. We'll have another recipe review video coming your way. I want to ask you, if you don't like this content, the vlog style content, if this bothers you, let me know. Tell me down below. This channel has my name on it, but it's really as much for you as it is for me. It's keeping me on a way of eating, for sure, that is making me feel better and lose weight and all of that. But the content is for you too. And if you'd rather me put these vlog style videos on maybe my own personal channel somewhere else away from highfalutin low carb, then I'll do that. Those of you who are watching want to see these personal style vlog videos that are related to low carb eating, but if you don't want to see these, then let me know and I'll move them away off of this channel. But this is a first. And if you do like them and you think that I can just keep these in another playlist on highfalutin and keep this up, then let me know there too. There's comments below. All right, like this video if you liked it. Subscribe if you're a subscriber. If you don't know me, I usually look a whole lot better than this. These are all during early in the morning because that's what I'm doing. I'm testing my fasting blood sugar. Love you guys. Appreciate all the support. The channel's growing so quickly, I've just never imagined. I hope here shortly I can do a 1,000 subscriber update. I thought that would be coming at the end of the year, not at the end of a month or two. So that's because of you. Appreciate it. Love you guys. See you next time.
Now, if you liked this video, hit the like button below, or better yet, like this video and subscribe to our channel. These videos are a way for me to maintain my focus on a low-carb eating plan. I've personally experienced the weight loss and better health that a low-carb lifestyle can produce, so I appreciate you guys coming along for the journey. We make videos every week, so if there's a low-carb recipe out there you'd like me to try, let me know in the comments below. We'll see you again soon.